Well, look who it is. Our old buddy Jay Moore. Hello, Jay.
Hi, boys.
How are you, pal?
Looking good. I heard Bob Dylan's getting back together.
But that would be fine.
Best concert I ever saw, Ronnie B. I saw Jane's Addiction at the Ritz in New York. It was 1991, right before they broke up the first time, and they were all drug addicts, and they all hated each other. And there was really just a terrific sense of malevolence in the building.
Hmm.
I never saw anything quite like it since. And every concert I see since then, I hold up to the light of that one concert.
That would be it for you. Jane's Addiction, 91.
Jane's Addiction at the Ritz, 91.
Jay, you're, unlike a lot of comics, you're a man who does enjoy music and does enjoy going to shows.
Oh, I love going to shows. It motivates me.
Yeah.
Because that, you know, I can't put on a rock show. I could try somehow through comedy, but it's, you know, what fascinates me. Remember Pearl Jam? Dave's about to ejaculate. Pearl Jam put out like every live show in the mid '90s on CD. Like
right.
They knew they couldn't make money off of it, and I would pull ones from like Lithuania and Turkey, and I realized this is just a Tuesday to them. Like, this is just a notch on their belt. Like, there's tanks in the street in this country, and they're up there doing even flow. Like, that was the most motivating thing about all those albums. And as far as Radiohead goes, fucking so long, Radiohead. Fuck them.
You're done with them, huh?
I'm just tired of the computer sounds. Like, play your instruments. Go back to Pablo Honey. Do songs like Creep and Blow Out. Like, play your fucking instruments instead of looking them up online.
Come on. Does that hurt you, Dave?
Yeah. I mean, Pablo Honey's a good album, Jay, but it doesn't hold a candle to OK Computer.
Yeah, but OK Computer was the watershed moment of electro rock and roll. It's the high watermark. And then follow it up with Hail to the Thief, which is like, now you're at the saturation point. It's more of the same, more layers, more fuzz, and you already accomplished it. Okay, Computer is like Miles Davis's Bitches Brew. We're halfway through, you get a little claustrophobic just from your ears, and you're not even sure what's going on. You just, something about this particular song is making me uncomfortable. Like, they accomplished it. And then you do Hail to the Chief, Hail to the Thief, and it's like twice as much overkill.
There were two albums in between those, though.
What? No, there was. You know, what's the one in between?
Kiday and Amnesiac were between Hail to the Thief and
Okay. You're right. You're absolutely correct.
And they're great albums.
Masterpieces, Amnesiac, masterpiece.
So, all right, so that's like three albums with the techno
right.
sound.
I will say this about Amnesiac, and Ronnie B., I don't know if you've listened to Amnesiac ever by Radiohead.
Mm. I'm not the biggest Radiohead fan in the world. When I hear them, I like them, but I don't, you know, I'm not
listen to listen to You and Who's Army and picture it in your mind in
great
a
call.
Scorsese movie.
All right, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to turn down a Scorsese movie and put this up. My thing is this, though, Jay. Most of the time, it's like, I don't try to tell the band how to do, you know, what kind of music to play. In the same way I wouldn't tell Scorsese, here's the kind of movies I want you to direct. I'll be open to it, and then if I don't like it, I don't like it. But I don't expect them to go backwards.
When I bought In Rainbows, I actually threw it away. But I was like, this is actually like a garbage album. And Dave, did you like In Rainbows?
Garbage? Yeah, he felt like he was watching garbage out there.
You mean Shirley Manson garbage? Yeah. Or just shit? Well, that's not just, there's a lot of guitars in Rainbows, actually. They kind of got some more guitars in that album.
Yeah, but there's only two guys playing guitars, so why would it be more than five guitars?
It hurts you for all this.
The album before that had eight guitars in it. I'm all for an overdub, but come on, guys. You know, what happened to fucking Three Chords and the Truth?
They're not that type of band. They never have been. I mean, it's like saying, you know, well, Pink Floyd, you fucking suck because you use lasers on animals.
Yeah, it's true. They do suck.
Yeah, but last I checked, Dave, a laser is not an instrument.
Laser
came out of phase. He meant a phaser.
It depends on what mushrooms you took.
The sound effects, you know what I mean.
I was on acid at the second.
That don't make you a bad person.
No, it doesn't. And I peeked coming over a hill, and Santana was on stage, and that fucker had lasers coming out of his guitar. It was amazing.
I saw a thing one time where I saw Notes on fucking stage. At a Frank Zappa. It was at a Frank Zappa show.
That's like Killing Zoe.
I know. I saw it was. It was just, I thought I was in Killing Zoe, and the movie hadn't even come out yet.
Right.
And I was like, this is like another movie years from now. But I did see fucking Notes hanging above the stage. And then later I'm saying to people, hey, how did they do that thing where they put the Notes up? Like, I didn't fucking. And they're like, what? You're so fucking high.
I was really high. I just took pot for Buckethead, and I thought he did this effect where he took off his hand and put his hand on the stage, and the hand started walking. I'm like, that's fucking Floyd. That's the best special effects of all time. People are like, what the? He didn't take his hand off.
It's always really scary when you're tripping and you find out they're not on the same trip as you.
Yeah. Hey, did you, have you ever had an acid flashback, but way too far after the fact, where it totally freaks you out and catches you off guard?
Oh, yeah, I've had that, but I talked about this with you with Unmasked. I do think that people have a panic attack. They think it's an acid flashback. Mm.
Well, you thought yours was a flashback.
Yeah. Or I thought, I don't know the difference between them both. So maybe just occasionally I have flashbacks.
I had a flashback. It was a good 3 years after I did acid.
Well, they say it stays in your spine.
I was walking through a courtyard of an apartment complex, and the lighting in the apartment complex were tiny rectangular lights in the walls along the pathway, but at, like, shoe level. You know what I mean? And in my flashback, in like about 6 seconds long, they were going back and forth, like when you see those bank movies and the lasers shoot across the floor of like the museum.
That's awesome.
See, and it just popped up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I opened the gate, they buzzed me in, I opened the gate, and I looked down, I went, whoa. But at the same time, it was like I had that wavy feeling in my body, and I went, oh man. And then I thought, did I get dosed? And then I realized, no. Wow, that was cool. And then I just went up to the person's apartment and just smoked a lot of grass.
Well, see, that's the thing. If you fucking smoke weed, it'll jump on you every once in a while. Well, just
every
like
once in a while. Yeah. Every once in a while, Ron. You can smoke a little too much weed where you don't realize you have a stuffy nose, and that's why you're short of breath.
Right. Fez, you were getting weirded out during the flashback talk?
Yeah, just the fact that that could creep up on somebody years and years after. I'm right here, Jay.
Hi, Fezzy.
How you doing, Jay Moore?
Good, I didn't even know you were there today.
Yeah, the flashback story is
he's
just
busting your balls a little bit.
And I'm not letting him.
No, I'm not.
Why not?
Because
no,
I... Because
I want to... Yes or no?
You can't talk over him. One of you guys has to talk.
All right, who's first?
I won a huge competition today. I won the first round of a Kiss My Ass match, and I am not letting Jay Moore's little shots get to me.
Okay, now it's my turn to talk.
Yeah.
It wasn't a shot, yes or no. Was that the first time you spoke since I've been on the phone for 8 minutes?
No, it is not.
Yes, it is. Replay
what,
it. That was the
what
first
were you saying,
thing you said.
I said something of. I said something about the effects. At one of the concerts.
No, that was with Dave before I called.
So, no, your shot is unwarranted, and it's...
I didn't hurt this shit again. Does anyone not hurt your feelings, Fez? Is there ever a day where you say, that person wouldn't hurt my feelings, they're my friend?
See, what happens is you try to throw in a shot and then act like, you know, I'm nuts for taking it as a shot.
I'm not taking part in this. Anyway, so that was the best concert I ever saw, Ronnie B.
Yeah.
And I had an acid flashback, and I'm sorry the conversation took a turn, and I'm punching out. I'm not doing this today.
Right.
I love you guys.
All right,
great
see
show.
You, buddy. You got a little thing going with him, Fezzy.
Yeah, he won't let it go. I only brought it up after his shot. And then I tried to ignore it, but he kept coming with it. So that's what happens there.
I'm going to take the next 8 minutes off in honor of Jay Moore.
Can't do that.
I think he just got upset because, you know, he got caught. I think that was the only reason. But he, I mean, it was a legitimate shot. I mean, he can't, and then act nice afterwards. That's just to make me look like I'm insane and I belong back in a mental institution again. And, I'm in a good mood, too. I destroyed in Batman Trivia. I pummeled Eastside Dave in that. And I was feeling good, so I wasn't gonna let the little Jay Moore jabs get to me. It just wasn't gonna happen. So, I mean, it's, you know, he got upset, but it really was, you know, a case of, you know, who started it. So I just say, you know, I was feeling strong today because I'm on top of the trivia competition. And I just, you know, pointed it out to him that I wasn't going to let him bother me as much as he tried. And he did try. AshleyMadison.com, they've got a new program that they're introducing. They're calling it Cash for Chunkers. So what they're saying is that if you have a wife that's over 200 pounds and the marriage isn't exactly the way you want it, the sex life isn't the way you want it, then you have AshleyMadison.com to go to. Over 4 million members at AshleyMadison.com. AshleyMadison.com, it is 100% safe, it is 100% secure, completely anonymous, and as they want to put it now, fat-free with their new Cash for Chunkers program. AshleyMadison.com, you're going to find what you're looking for because they guarantee it. You will have an affair to remember at AshleyMadison.com. They're going to make sure that you find what you want, and if you don't, they will give you your money back. That's all of what they're calling Cash for Chunkers at AshleyMadison.com. You can sign up today free of charge, and they will take care of you. Every 60 seconds, another woman joins AshleyMadison.com. You can sign up today and sleep with someone else's wife tonight. That's how it works. AshleyMadison.com. Life is short. Have an affair at AshleyMadison.com. So, but, you know, it's a, you know, so if I need to go back to the Jay Moore thing, you know, I don't want Jay to go away mad, but I wasn't the one that took a shot. I didn't bring anything up. I thought I was doing okay. I thought I was doing all right. And then he got upset and went away again. I don't mean to upset him, but he is the one who said something. That's how it went.
I'm halfway through my 8 minutes of silence in honor of Jay Moore. I stand with you, Jay.
And it's nice, and I believe I was talking when Jay came on. I don't think, you know, I didn't talk a lot, but, you know.
You weren't.
I was there.
Nope.
And so he was just, you know, looking for a little shot. I mean, I can understand it. I can, you know, what happens. But this is a turnaround now. This is a... I've already won the Batman trivia competition. Hopefully, I will win round three.
You haven't mentioned that 8 times in the last minute and a half.
And I will hope, you know, I have every intention on winning round three. Now, mention...
That should impress Jay. He has a TV show.
Well, anything I can do to come back, you know, and prove Jay Moore wrong. Where he doesn't feel the need.
Well, he's our friend.
Well, he says, and I like Jay Moore, but, you know, why take the little shots? Why try to pass them off like that? And I did my best to take the higher ground. That's usually what I like to do. I'll take a higher ground. You know, if Jay wants to go to that level, that's one thing. But then I have to answer back eventually, I guess. So I was, you know, I was talking about,
2 minutes. You were mentioning Batman trivia.
Well, I did win the Batman trivia thing first thing today, earlier on the show. So, it's, you know, that's just the way it goes. I'm sorry he's upset, but I did nothing to upset him. I got nothing to be sorry about in that respect. So, I'm sure he's still listening, but I mean, he, you know, he brought it up. He's the one who did it.
Nobody's listening now.
So, it's just, sorry it had to end that way, but that's, I guess, that's the way it goes. That's the way Jay wants it. That was his decision, not mine. I did not chase Jay Moore away. That was his call to hang up. It was his call to take a shot at me. And apparently I'm supposed to sit here like a target. That's when people get upset, when I don't just sit here and, you know, let someone take a shot at me. If I call them on it, they get very upset back. Because I guess I'm not fulfilling their needs by sitting here and being a punching bag for them. So, that's just the way it goes.
He's where? Up front?
I'm sorry Jay had a problem with that, but I wasn't going to sit here with a target on me.
I got 23 more seconds.
So, that's... too bad it had to end that way. It wasn't my intention. I wasn't looking for any trouble. I wasn't looking for a fight. But it just absolutely turned out that way.
All right, my 8 minutes is up. Michael Lang has a brand new book called The Road to Woodstock. Should I stay on for him? Or break? We
got a guest coming
in. Stay on. This is my 8 minutes off. Hey, Rob in Winnipeg, you're running Fez. Once, twice.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, Rob.
Hey, Fez, congratulations on your win over stupid-ass Eastside Dave today. And second of all, I don't think you were right in your situation there with Jay Moore. I think you had said nothing, and he didn't give you a shot. He just didn't hear you talking. I don't think it was a shot at all.
I totally think it was a shot, Rob. I really, really do.
I think you're just being the victim, as usual. You just want to... everybody to feel sorry for you, so you make yourself sound like you're the victim all the time.
Dude, he brought it up. He threw out the shot. I didn't say anything like, oh, there's Jay picking on me or anything like that.
Jay just was sitting there talking about a concert, and then you pipe in with something out of nowhere, and he's all, oh, Fez, I didn't know you were there. And once again, you're taking like a
not
shot,
for nothing.
And then you're the poor, poor Fez victim as usual.
Wouldn't it have been just as easy to say, hey, Jay, you know me, I don't know music. And I move on from there. I got nothing to add.
I guess so, but I mean, I heard a shot and I responded to it.
I don't think it was a shot. I think the guy likes you. Should I take another 8 minutes off for Jay Moore?
No, I don't think so.
I took that 8 minutes off, Fez.
Uh-huh.
Couldn't do it. Don't know how you do it. Don't know how you can sit here and let eight blow by. It was driving me crazy. I just started to whisper like maybe that wasn't cheating.
Awkward.
I'd go out of my mind. What was awkward? Fez rocking on?
Just the whole Jay Moore thing.
What happened with you and Jay anyway? Everything was going along great, blah, blah, blah.
Acid stories.
Yeah, we're telling acid stories.
I was enjoying his acid stories. I didn't have an acid story ever in my life to throw out there. But then the little shot came in.
I'm not sure if it was a shot.
You don't think it was, really?
I think... he might, you know, because we were real excited about acid stories, and I don't think he heard Fez. And Jay, I mean, I can't speak for him, though.
What did he do that made you mad, Fezzy?
It was, oh, is Fez there? So I just thought that was a little shot. I mean, it sounds like it to me. It sounds like, and then, like, no, and then he, you know, started claiming
it. Why would he do it? Jay loves you.
He does.
Yeah, but I know there's other people that he's friends with, that he talks to online, that there's a relationship set up online. So it just seems like a pattern of behavior.
Is that me?
You think Dave had him do that?
I don't know if Dave was in on it, but, you know, I don't want to break any treaty in here or anything.
I have no idea what he's talking about now. Do you?
No.
I know a lot of times you think you're being kind of obvious, and the rest of us don't know what you mean.
Yeah. I think it just came from the McDonald camp. Oh, let me put it that way. Friends with Jay Moore. Go ahead, get your shot in. when you call. It just smelled of setup to me.
So you're saying my wife called Jay, tell him to call in with funny acid stuff, and then remark something about Fez.
No, I think I'm being played by both of them.
I know they're Twitter pals.
I can't even fucking tell anymore.
I am completely...
I swear to God, I feel like I get gaslighted.
We should just drop acid. Just leave this reality.
All right, let's go to JQ, Fezzy.
I'm going to
look over here. Who you say is in your camp now.
Yes.
And I haven't seen the email yet, but I will also say maybe one of the world's biggest Jay Moore fans.
Okay.
And as I want to go to this, it's not popping up on my email, and I wanted to read it. Sometimes that this freaking thing gets so damn slow here.
It has to be fixed.
Ted, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, boys.
Yeah.
Just hear me out here. I'm not calling in the race shit or anything, but I mean, I know Jay Moore is getting bigger and bigger as a star all the time.
Yeah.
But like Jimmy Norton says, fuck Jay Moore. I'm kind of on Fezzy's side on this, because for Jay to call in, like for that to go down, there has to be some assumptions, and one of them is that, you know, Fez isn't around today. Fez didn't show up for the show today. So was he actually thinking that, okay, Fez didn't show up for work today, maybe he's off sick, you know, maybe he's got the heart problems.
Yeah, but Fezzy could have played it a little, he didn't have to just jump right back up into him, he could have went, you know, he could have done what I told him to do, too. JQ Fezzy says, I think Jay Moore likes Fez, but yes, that is a shot.
All right, thank you, JQ.
And you said you got JQ now as your concierge.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
You see this as a battle.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm lining up with JQ. JQ lining up with me.
And JQ also is on RonFez.net, but by a different name.
Right.
She posts under Death Mail Mo.
Why do you always go attack Mo?
I love him.
I will say this. Sleeves has sent us a song, Fezzy, that I haven't listened to it, but from what I understand from Hicks, he took it as anti-Fez.
Okay.
And told me he didn't want to play it. So I know that you think Hicks is close with Dave, but he's got your back here.
All right. It's hard to tell from the last 10 minutes that we've been back on the air from the spots.
Why? What happened there?
Where Hicks was taken up for Dave and the great job he did with the guests out in the hallway.
But giving us the wrong information.
Yeah, just fantastic job. I don't know why you wouldn't back that up.
Boy, it's tense around here.
Danes. It's dense around here. Deji.
You know, at one point I would have thought this would have been my dream job. Dream job, dream city, dream personal life.
Dream weaver?
I felt like Earl Weaver more than the dream weaver. But I have to admit, I'm not having a great deal of fun sometimes with you guys.
I hear you.
You're not having fun lately
It's
either?
My dream job, though, still. Yeah. I don't know why there's got to be so many dangies. I don't know.
Well, I'm told to hold on tighter, but I don't know. I wanted to fucking, like 38 Special say, hang on loosely. Richie in Maryland.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Yeah.
You know, Fez, I really like you a lot. I find you very entertaining. But when Jay Moore calls and he makes a comment like that, I think it's totally insane for you to take it as a shot. You're blowing it way out of proportion, and it's paranoia, dude. You're just being totally paranoid. If anything, he was giving you some advice, like to say, hey, dude, 8 minutes goes by, you didn't say a fucking word. You know, pipe up a little bit. It's your show.
Richie, congratulate yourself because you fell for it. They want you to say that I'm crazy.
Who's they?
I will say it again. The McDonald camp, apparently working with online friend Jay Moore.
I want you to swear to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say swear on your niece and nephew.
Okay.
Do you believe this to be true?
I swear on my niece and nephew to Jesus, I believe this to be true.
My wife is at the doctor's.
But by the way, do you believe him when he says this?
He doesn't believe in Jesus, so I don't know what to believe myself. But my wife was at the doctor's.
I didn't say everything had to be done, put together in the last second.
But I wanted you to know something. Jay Moore, he's on his way to his second season of Gary Unmarried.
Right.
He's doing great. He's got a TV show. He's got a nice life. He chooses to call us and be our buddy. You gotta fucking see that as a positive thing. You can't always see everything as a negative.
Well, I understand that, but I also...
How could you and think that he has teamed up with the McDonald camp to destroy your life and your position? Do you honestly think that a TV star in Los Angeles and Hollywood, California...
Mr. Holly.
...is out to destroy your life, teaming up with this fucking ham and egg or nobody, Eastside Dave? No fucking... No shot at you, Dave.
Well, but, it sounds like it.
No, but you see my point. Like,
oh, yeah,
you
know,
honestly
he's a big
think,
star.
Yeah, he's a big star.
Yeah, no, that's true. I'm not going to deny that. I mean, I'd love to one day be as half of the star that Mr. Holly is.
If you were half of what Jay Moore's done, you'd be a very successful person.
I know. You know. That's why I said it.
But my point is this. Is he really going to take his time? This is like saying... If this was the 70s, I think Bob Newhart's fucking with me at my job. I mean, it's just kind of crazy.
He took the time to show Dave and his wife his asshole at a comedy show. So what am I supposed to know?
It's just
friends.
I don't
know what that means.
We were just friends hanging
Ryan
out.
Ryan in Texas.
Hey, Fez, I mean, this is a buddy of yours that's also a comedian that took a little shot at you, but it's no different than what you do every time that Hard Rock Johnny calls with the fat jokes. He's just joking around with you. There's nothing serious there.
I wish you would stop those jokes with Johnny, by the way. I know they hurt his feelings a little bit.
Okay, but but all I was doing was pointing out that it was a shot. That's all I did.
Yeah,
that
but
he
why,
didn't get it past me.
But why couldn't you think of it as like a roast thing? Like you're in on a roast. You're not saying it's a shot. You're saying he's teamed up with the McDonald clan, as you're putting it, to usurp you from your chair.
Yes.
Then that's not just a little shot. That's, this would be, this is fucking Shakespearean. This is Hamlet time.
Richard III.
Is this a roast or is it Hamlet? All right, I'll go Richard III with you.
Well, I just don't see Jay Moore as this type of scheming person. He's a movie/television star. Usually they're concentrated about, I don't know.
Slash,
like
did something happen? Eric in Florida.
Yeah, Fez, this is a comedy show, buddy. They're telling you jokes. They're hitting you with jokes, man. You got to take them as jokes. See ya.
Joe in Nebraska.
Hey, Fezzy. I think that you might be a little on the paranoid delusional side, and I think maybe you might need to get help other than your therapist. And, hey, Dave, I got that thing done that you wanted me to get done for Fez. You know the thing I'm talking about.
Yeah. All right, let me say this.
Clever.
Really. You and your concierge, you believe, you would tell me, some of the shots taken at you online and from the callers are not just individuals, but a wave of people working together run by the McDonald camp.
Yeah, an orchestrated wave, yes. Totally.
When would I be have time? Forget about
anyone has orbits. Here's the thing. If we're going to take out orbits, make sure everybody gets
Sorry.
Little orbits.
When would I have time to do it? Forget about Jay Moore.
Oh, trust me,
no,
I'm not thinking you're the mastermind.
He talked to
trust
me,
Trust me, I don't think you're the brains of the organization.
But why would you set up something that he was going to say that when you know that's what he's talking about?
I'm thick-headed and didn't realize that that would be the response.
Thick-headed is nothing to brag about.
I agree. You know, my wife is busy taking care of two children. I can't really say enough.
Billy in Georgia.
Hey, Ron and Fez.
Yeah.
I'm a long-time listener. Ron and Ron show back in high school and stuff. And Fez, I'm a big fan, man. But if you continue to progress like you have been, you're just going to slip. I mean, you're losing it, man. And I'm a fan. And I wish you all the best. I hope...
That's the way the plan works.
What is the plan?
To... take away any authority I have here.
Okay.
To disrespect me on the air, turn listeners on message boards against me, and get me out of here.
And you are, you swear you believe this to be true.
I absolutely believe it to be true. Totally believe it.
And is that why the Batman trivia contest felt so fantastic to you today?
Yeah.
Because I did think that you were taking it a little too serious.
I was gleeful over that Batman trivia contest. That it wasn't, you know, another chance to just beat on Fez. And to make me look stupid. Unfortunately, it just didn't work out that way for them.
What about the way that then Dave went and put together a bit that he said took him 3 hours doing line for line a bit of Opie's?
Yeah, he's never worked 3 hours on a bit.
Yes, I have.
So all honesty, what do you think about that bit and Dave's thing behind it? Is that part of the bigger deal to make you look?
Oh, sure, yes. It absolutely is, Ron. I'll swear to Jesus again if I need to.
But you don't like Jesus.
Why bring that up? He's not blasphemous. He might be angry, but he's not a blasphemous person.
Okay.
I think that this is all really just starting to... We're really starting to see how deep this runs in Fez's mind.
Okay, well, if it's for real...
Well, yes, it is for real, Dave. And here's the thing. You could say that it's not true, but to him it is true.
Okay, I understand.
And it got to that point where Fez thinks that this is true. Here's TJ in New York.
What's up, buddies? Yeah. Two things real quick. Fez, number one, I think it's kind of egotistical of you to think that people are spending that much time going out of their way to plot against you. That's number one. And number two, if by chance they really are, you're playing right into their hands by showing it bothers you. I mean, if they really are, then fuck them. You're you, man. This is half of your show, bro. Be you.
See, I'm just not going to let the shots keep going by, though.
You've had it.
I'm feeling better. I'm feeling stronger. That's what, you know, went wrong with their plan. Is nobody expected me to, you know, to point it out, to come back on it.
How many people do you think were involved in the plan altogether?
Well, I think there's several people involved. A lot of people don't even know that they've been put into it.
Okay, so there's...
Like a lot of people on RonFez.net is what I mean by that.
They're being used as sheep, pawns.
Right. You know,
they're being played to.
Yeah. Anti-Fez things get out there or things that make me look bad and people will jump on it.
Am I in the plan?
I don't think so. I would certainly hope not.
Is Hicks in the plan?
Hicks, I wonder. Hicks seems to be like he just wants to get his job done and do a good job. But sometimes I wonder about it.
All right, I'm going to give you a couple of people's names.
Uh-huh.
Jay Moore?
In.
In on the plan.
Yes.
Steve Blatter?
Out.
Not in.
Yeah, not
but
in.
But the plan's supposed to play to him.
Oh, right, yeah.
Jeremy Coleman?
Not in on the plan.
Opie?
Could be in on the plan. In on the plan.
Anthony?
I don't think Anthony cares. Not in on the plan.
Jimmy Norton?
Not in on the plan.
But Opie?
Opie in on the plan.
And that's what happened with that bit thing, you think?
Oh, probably. I mean, if Dave had such a hard time finding it, you know, maybe Opie went
back and recorded it?
Yeah, or worked with Sam, you know, to find it.
So Sam in on the plan?
Sam in on the plan.
And Rick had to have worked on that.
Who's Rick?
Audio, too, because he's laughing in the background. The Opie bit.
Sean in Illinois.
Yo, what's up, guys? Hey, Fez, I'm with you, bro. I've been sensing this for a while now. I think Eastside Dave is out to get you. I think he's using Jay Moore as his little tool to get little stabs at you, and I watch your back because that little fucker's going after your job.
All right, let's go over this. The McDonald's.
Yes, in.
Beanie?
In.
Hicks?
I'm going to say in.
Ronnie B?
Not in.
Anthony?
Not in.
Jimmy Norton?
Not in.
Opie?
In.
Now, I talk to Anthony on Fridays. We text back and forth.
Because that's your drinking day?
Yeah.
That's nothing to brag about.
Just saying that.
Is there any other big players in the plan that we're not available, that we're not sure of? Do you think I could know about the plan?
No, I don't think so. I don't think anyone would bring this to you.
Right. So I'm the dupe here. I'm the rube.
That's right. Ron Bennington. The Bennington. World's biggest
rube. Do me
a
favor.
Rube.
Say my last fucking name correctly.
Bennington.
I hit with Bennington like I'm a the same way you said Gumnet. HTG? And on the plan?
I'd say no. Not in the plan. Nope.
She's the one who got you going to that stupid piano bar that they all laugh about. Mikey Boy?
Mikey Boy, I don't think is in on the plan. I really don't.
Who do you feel close with? Who's in the Fez camp?
Got we mentioned Death Metal Mo.
Yeah.
Got my JQ.
Yeah.
I got Ronnie B.
Mm-hmm. Fred from Brooklyn?
Fred from Brooklyn, definitely I got.
Mafia Life Chris?
I don't think I have Mafia Life Chris.
So he's in on the plan.
Could it probably?
Dean.
Dean from Brooklyn.
I think I got Dean.
That's a joke to you?
Yeah.
Because they're close?
Because I'm friends with Dean.
Very, very confused.
Pedro starts tonight against the Cubs. That's the thing to watch.
George in Arizona.
Hey, I just wanted to say, down here in Tucson, we've been in on it for a long time.
Tucson knows about the plan.
It's a good state. A city. Whatever.
Well, I'm going to do the adult thing, and after the show today, I'm going to try my best to get the lawyers to let Dave and Fez suck each other's ball sacks. And I really didn't think I'd be in this conversation at this point. They think, as of right now, it's come across as homoerotic.
Oh, okay.
And I'm trying to say it's more insulting than sex.
Yeah.
Spirit of competition is what it is.
Think gross, not homosexuality.
We can close the curtains. I mean, that's what they're there for.
Well, we can do it. We can't take a picture. And without the picture being up on RonFez.net,
it's just dirty.
It's just, I don't want to be here for it. If it's not like a disgusting joke, then it's just disgusting. What about Barb? In on the plan?
Could be in on the plan. Possibility.
Franklin? Earl?
Franklin and Earl not in on the plan.
Are they on your team?
Earl's with me.
Said.
Good crew over there. I got Jay Moore and Opie. He's got Franklin and Earl.
I haven't been working this as long.
You plan on working it?
I'm going to have to.
Start win back the hearts and minds? Well, the plan's been exposed.
It's out there. Just surprised I didn't see it sooner.
How long has your shrink been away?
I think a week.
Only a week?
I think only a week, yeah.
Does the shrink know about the plan?
No. Nope. The shrink left before I discussed the plan.
You might want to discuss that with the shrink. Just to see if the plan makes sense. All right, that is it for us. We'll be back here tomorrow with the plan. It's all happening. It's all going down. It's a plan.
Fuck yeah.
Fezzy, I know exactly who's behind the plan. And it runs up right to the highest parts of the...
And that's the end of my show, Donk.
All right, Ron and Fez show, 866 Ron Zero Fez, 866 Ron Zero Fez. Fez, you said, I want to pull you into the show today. It's been me and Dave a lot. I'm worried Jay Moore is going to call later, and you're not going to be involved. He's going to say, is Fez there? And then you're going to get your feelings hurt and start fighting, but you're not jumping in today.
Yeah, sorry about that.
What's going on?
Nothing. I just, It was,
What's happening over there? What's up with the big cat?
Just a big cat day, I guess. So, I guess that's the problem.
Should I ignore you? Would it be more comfortable? Because now you seem uncomfortable.
No, don't ignore me.
Turn my back on you?
No, don't do that. No shunning.
What would you like to talk about? Let's let Fezzy take a subject, and then we'll all go with it.
I saw this commercial.
Oh, it looks, on your TV?
Yes, it's the worst commercial ever. It's for an Alzheimer's drug. The family shows up at Grandma's house for Sunday dinner to have their Sunday lasagna that she makes. Grandma forgets what day it is, so everybody freaks out that there's no lasagna, and Grandma forgot. They get her on the Alzheimer's drug, and then they start showing her grandma in the kitchen, and she's cooking the sauce, and she's making the noodles, and she's setting the table, and everyone is thrilled again. And it seems like the only reason they got her this drug was to put this poor old lady back to work.
Mm-hmm.
So it just seems like a bad way to sell a drug.
Commercials are stupid. They are.
Well, this one is, anyway.
Yeah, I haven't seen it, but it sounds like a real dumb one.
It's awful.
Sounds like it. Sounds like a bad one.
I was thinking of this, too.
You got another one?
Yeah.
All right.
What
was this commercial?
This wasn't a commercial. Well, I guess it was. I guess it was District 9.
Okay.
But if aliens came to this planet...
Yeah.
I would be disappointed if they didn't come to this country. I would feel bad because it seems like they would have studied the planet enough to know where they wanted to set down at.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently, if they go somewhere else, our country wasn't the place they wanted to make contact. There was someone else that they deemed more appropriate or at least better in some respect to make contact with.
This District 9 show, Scott, you mad?
Yeah, well, it comes out tomorrow.
But didn't they break down there?
You know what? I don't know for sure. I don't know.
If they broke down, you'd be okay.
Yeah, with that. But if they're picking another country to go to, as dangerous as the aliens may be, I would still want them in our country. I wouldn't trust another country to be able to deal with the alien presence.
You're like me, Fezzy, USA first. You like the USA.
Well, as far as aliens are concerned, you know, we don't know if they go to some other country. They're in China. We don't know if the Chinese are pissing them off. We don't know if they're cozying up to them, taking them the alien technology.
Good point. We need to get the aliens to come here. Steve in Long Island.
Fezzy, I love you, but I think you're drinking Dave's dumb aid, man. That Alzheimer ad is to show that her life is back to the way it was. Not that they're using her as a slave, that she's back to normal. That's all it's showing, Fez.
They could do that without making her a workhorse.
Don't you understand that that's a family tradition? Can you not understand that in that commercial? Is it really that difficult for you to do? I know you're not an idiot. That's why it really blows my mind that you don't get this.
I haven't seen the commercial.
I understand what they're going for, but all you're seeing is an old woman working away in the kitchen. I think there's a better way to show that she's back to her normal way of life.
Here is Jim in Indiana. Jim.
Yeah, I got sad news to the guitar world today. Les Paul dead, I think, at the age 94.
Wow, is that right? That's just heartbreaking.
I drive a truck for a living. My girlfriend just called me and told me. So.
You know, it was, I guess, just a couple years ago, I walked over in the Hard Rock... Johnny invited me over something, and Les Paul was standing there. And it was just the craziest thing. And he looked great. And was still wearing one of those satin jackets like they used to back in, like, a 70s tour jacket. There's nothing to me funnier than a 70s satin tour jacket. They're just the best.
Hey, he was rocking that for a long, long time.
Yeah, he was making it work for him.
I mean, best guitar out there, probably.
Rich in Long Island. Rich.
Ronnie, Fezzy, what's up? Hey, Ronnie, get Fezzy on some of that Alzheimer's disease. Maybe we can get him back to work, the little old lady.
I did see, I thought was Fez today, and it was a woman with a bad shirt. You've been wearing such loud bad shirts.
Right.
That I'm coming down the block, and I see it, and I go, oh, there's Fez. And it was just some old woman.
I would have liked to know where she got it.
Here is Nick in Missouri.
Yeah, good afternoon, guys. I just want to know, Fezzy, what would be better, if you bring the lady back using the drugs and let her cook lasagna for her family, or put her in an old age home and let her die like your family did with your grandmother?
Oof, that was brutal.
Yeah, yeah. Well, my grandmother was at the point where she was basically in a coma, so yeah, we should have kept her at home.
There's a plan out there, Fezzy. Don't fall in against the plan.
Mm-hmm.
You explained the plan to us yesterday.
Right, yes.
What was that?
The plan is that there's people that conspire against me. That there are people that work together. They try to portray themselves as victims and me as a maniac nut. And that way it undermines any authority I have here. It disrespects me. It turns the tide against me.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the plan. And I think there's, you know, few people in on it.
Who are the people?
Well, I think Dave and his wife are in on it.
Mm-hmm.
I would say I questioned yesterday that Jay Moore was probably in on it.
Yeah.
I think there is, I wouldn't be surprised if Opie was in on it.
Why?
I just have the feeling. It's just a feeling that I have.
Is it because he went back in time and stole your bit?
No. No, it's not because of that.
Let's play the Fez Opie bit. From yesterday, I teased Fez because he went on one of his rants, like he did with his commercial thing here today. But I had heard Opie do it years before, and you know, teased you, and then you ended up getting very mad and felt like there was a plan against you. But let's go back and play the bit that Dave put together.
So back to school's coming up. It is. And I remember the year that I decided I wasn't going to take a lunchbox anymore. I wanted that bag lunch.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, it cost too much money to get the small brown paper bags for my lunch.
Well, instead of getting the small bags to put my lunch in...
My goddamn lunch. A lousy peanut butter and jelly sandwich and a bruised apple.
Didn't have those. Ended up taking my lunch to school in one of those giant grocery brown paper bags.
A huge, huge... Wallbaum's paper bag.
So it just looked enormous and ridiculous.
Now let me guess, in those days, did your mom used to call you Opie? Because that's his story.
Small brown paper bag.
866 Ron Zero Opie. That's Ron and Opie. Jerry in Kansas.
Hey, yeah. Hey, this is Jerry in Kansas. I've never really listened to the show. I usually listen to O&A, but I was just kind of checking it out. And is this, is Fez delusional?
How would you describe yourself, Fez?
I think I have some emotional problems, but I wouldn't say I'm delusional. I think I deal with some phobic and anxiety issues.
Robin in Missouri.
Yeah, hey, guys, I just wondered, Fez, if this conspiracy, who's in charge of the conspiracy that makes you say you know at least 200 times a show?
Well, it's a verbal crutch that I get on.
Holy cow, it drives me crazy.
What, now you're upset, Fez?
Yeah.
What was it?
Apparently, I just don't do anything right. I'm sorry. I shouldn't let things get to me, I guess.
What got to you?
Where I'm seriously trying. I really, really am trying.
And I brought you into the show, I shouldn't have.
No, not at all. You totally should have. That's my job to do
I
that.
I don't understand what just got you upset. Just the caller?
Yeah, the caller got me upset. And I'm trying to fix some things. And it just feels like sometimes it's much harder to fix some things. I had every intention of coming in here and having a good show. I wanted to, and it's like, and I'm sorry, I'm really sorry to everybody that didn't happen.
I don't even know what you're talking about, dude. I swear to God to you, I have no idea where you think this show went sideways. Other than me bringing you. What did you do that was so wrong?
Nothing.
What just happened?
I didn't have an answer back for the guy who said you know. Who brought up the you know comment. And it bugged me because he's, you know, in my mind, I felt he was right. I do say you know a lot. And I don't mean to do it. I don't realize I'm doing it. And it just caught me out of nowhere.
Have some fun with it.
That's what I should do. That's what I should do. That's why I'm apologizing.
Why are you writing so loudly during the show? I just hear you scratching over there, Dave.
I'm sorry.
What the hell are you writing down? It's like you're fucking chiseling into goddamn stone.
Sorry, but this pen, it might be the pen.
What are you writing so fucking important? You're working on a novel?
No, I take notes during the show. And
for what?
In case things can be made into production later on. I take the time and...
So you just hear him having a bad moment.
No,
you
that wasn't...
scribbling away.
No, and also...
And what is he... he's done one production piece.
Right.
And I knew that wasn't relevant, so I just wanted to keep it to myself, but I had to write it down to remember.
Why write so big and large?
In case I had to hand the note to Ron, I want him to see it clearly.
Mike in D.C., Mike.
Hey, Fezzy.
Yes, sir.
If you're not, here's the thing. It seems to me like you have a good amount of money. You have a great job. You have people who want to always know you and be around you and hang out with you. It seems like you have everything going for you. So, you know, if you're not going to take advantage of this stuff, why don't you just start giving it away? Why don't you move on from this job? You know, give away your money. Go live in a monastery or some shit somewhere.
Because you know what? Because I don't want to. That's not what I want for me.
What's this new bit that you say you got? That you're writing down, you got a new bit.
Yes. Well, as we discussed today and yesterday, a lot of talk of a plan. So I put together a theatrical, kind of a movie trailer about the plan.
This is the plan that Fez thinks that people are lining up against him.
Yes.
Is this going to be helpful to you, Fez? Have you heard it?
I have not heard this at all. I didn't even know this project was in the works.
I was, I was working on it last night. Everyone was
I'm
out.
Curious why you think, and if I'm going to be totally honest here, we rarely even run into O&A.
Mm-hmm.
Even though we've, you know, come up to 11 o'clock, they normally get off at 10:30. They bolt out of here as they should. We come in late as we should. We don't get to see them as much as we even like to.
Right.
Why would you think Opie is against you?
Well, I thought Opie was in on the plan from that production piece that we just played by Dave.
But Opie said that years ago.
Right, yeah, but I was thinking, Dave, I just am suspicious of how he would find the audio of Opie so many years ago. And was Opie, you know, behind helping him out with that project?
So, like, if he asked Opie, Opie would say, yeah, here's where I said it. And that would make him against you.
Well, I would think it would make him in the Dave camp.
Yeah, I don't get that. Just so you know,
mm-hmm.
That doesn't make a huge amount of sense. I mean, that's one of the things that would sound delusional. All right, let's listen to Dave's production piece.
They come from the bowels of hell, a transformed race of walking dead, zombies guided by a master plan for complete domination of the Earth. Plan 9 from outer space.
What is the plan?
They want you to say that I'm crazy.
How many people do you think were involved in the plan altogether?
Well, I think there are several people involved. A lot of people don't even know that they've been put into it.
What earthly power can stop this terror?
Am I in the plan?
I don't think so. I would certainly hope not.
For a glimpse of things to come, see this blast of screen suspense. For it could be happening right now.
Is Hicks in the plan?
Hicks, I wonder.
Jay Moore?
In.
In on the plan?
Yes.
Opie?
Opie in on the plan.
So Sam in on the plan?
Sam in on the plan.
It is safe to state that the grandchildren of some of the people in this theater will not be born on Earth.
The McDonald's.
Yes, in.
Beanie?
In.
Ronnie B?
Not in.
Anthony?
Not in.
Jimmy Norton?
Not in.
Opie?
In.
They come from the bowels of hell, a transformed race of walking dead, zombies guided by a master plan for complete domination of the Earth. Plan 9 from outer space.
That's what, you know, went wrong with their plan.
All right, the plan sounds a little nutty when you hear it like that.
Yeah. But that's the plan. It's to make me sound nutty.
Are you serious right now?
Yes, I am. Completely serious. That's the plan.
And you think the people in the plan were behind what that caller said that got you upset?
See, that's where I said, and people don't know that they're in on the plan. It's those kind of things. It's the shots in here that, you know, the disrespectfulness that comes from Dave in here that leads the callers to do these things.
That got the plan started.
Yes. That's where it starts. That's where the ball starts rolling against me.
E-Rock in on the plan?
No. E-Rock is not in on the plan.
Because I saw him and Dave and Sam talking.
Mm-hmm. I don't think they would get E-Rock in on the plan.
What do you think? You just nodded at me.
Well, I mean, I think he might be part of the plan. If but I don't think there is a plan.
Right.
I don't. There is no plan, in my opinion.
Is there a plan, Fez?
But if there was.
Oh, there's totally a plan.
I wonder why I wasn't asked to be in on the plan. Which now I'm thinking.
It's a fun group of people.
Well,
me, Pepper,
I was,
Opie.
Just ask me. I could turn you down. You know, just like when you have your barbecue, Dave.
Right.
You know I ain't going to come, but ask me.
Okay.
So I could turn you down.
Yeah, right.
That's where I want to be with the plan.
I got
it. I don't want to be on the plan.
All right.
What I'd like to say is, thank you for asking, but I'm very busy.
Okay.
Doing things you don't even know about.
Okay.
Do they meet online in the plan?
I don't know how they work it out.
Let me ask you this. Rob Cross, in on the plan?
No, not in on the plan.
Very close with special delivery now. Very close.
I may have to give him another look.
Dave in Arkansas.
Hey, Wally Posse member checking in. Hmm. Hey, while I was on hold, Fez said, you know, three times. Can I get into the big-ass prize closet?
I'm not even noticing this, you know, thing. You notice that you do it?
No, I don't notice that I do it.
Well, then why did you get so upset?
Because I'm sure I do it.
Why?
Because why? I know I do go into verbal crutches sometimes. Hmm. I've been known to do that.
I don't doubt it
for a second.
Everybody does it. Listen to any show and everybody will have their own verbal crush. Mine right now is blueberries. Give me blueberries. Ronnie in Georgia. Ronnie.
Yeah, Fezzi's problem is the medications, the antidepressants cause paranoid delusions. A buddy of mine's wife, just before she killed herself, she sounded just like you. Everybody was out to get her. Nothing was her fault. And it's just outrageous, crazy shit just going on and on and on. And it was the medication.
Well, you're off the antidepressants, right, Fez?
Yeah, I haven't been on antidepressants in months and months and months.
You think maybe you need to be back on? Because that's when the plan came around.
Oh, no, no. Those things are murder on me. I can't do them. I mean, I don't want to suggest anything for anyone else. I'm not a doctor. But those things, those things destroy me. No, I am not. I am not giving medical advice here. But those things destroy me. They will make me crazy.
So you think you
and
might
start shaking out of my boots, too.
You think you might be a little crazy?
No, No, I'm not crazy. I got a couple of emotional issues, but that by but not by a long shot am I crazy.
Hmm. So this isn't paranoia. This is you dealing with stuff that's going on.
Right, and this is something that's been going on for a long time. Dave's disrespect for me in here, Dave trying to turn listeners against me, callers against me.
But remember,
it's been going on for a long time, and a lot of times I just, you know, in my dark days, I wasn't able to fight back. Now I'm pointing it out to people. Now I'm letting people know what it is. So the return strategy, I guess everyone was shocked that I was, you know, finally doing that. So the return strategy is make him out to be a nut.
Who's make you, Dave's a nut? Who's the strategy? Yours or his?
His.
Okay. So when you started to defend yourself,
mm-hmm.
then Dave and the people in the plan said, let's now paint him like a nut.
Sure. Yeah.
Let me hear the bit that they did about our buddy Danny, because Danny came in here today and he seemed a little upset. He wants to get an XM versus Sirius thing going. It's about that time. There's two kinds of people in this world, XM and Sirius. And we've been trying to get along with them. And then they go and say the worst thing they can about Danny. So let's take a little listen.
Yo, it's a Little Nicky joint featuring P.E. Yo, Danny, no one ever talked before. Never even met you, man. But still.
Fuck you!
Danny is a fag. Fucking douchebag. Bag. Got a ponytail.
Tail.
Looks like a she-male.
I have sex with my guy friends.
He's a homo.
Sex with my guy friends.
We're homo.
Razzle dazzle.
And he's balding.
I wonder what kind of mortis they have.
In his 20s.
Oh,
how'd you get here, Danny?
I'm not good at anything.
Did you ask your mommy?
Mommy, can I be on the Opie and Anthony show?
Of course you can, honey. You're a homo.
Danny, what you drinking? Your breath is always kicking. Maybe it's the cock that you've been
homo.
Licking,
she wanted Austin Powers, instead she got Ed Powers.
Homo, Danny likes to butt fuck fat dude's name Chuck, and he's got his balls tucked. Here's a random duck. Danny's always drinking, puking in the sink, and drinking from the cup that he puffs.
I think I get the bit. You know what this is? A declaration of war. If I see this Little Nicky kid around, I'm going to snap his neck.
And where the fuck does he come off thinking that song is entertaining? Why is that the insult? And just repeating the word over and over again. How is that any sort of comedy? It's not funny. Mm. It's really lame.
Mm.
It's childish.
What don't you like?
All the sexist slurs. All the anti-gay slurs in it.
Well, what he's trying to do, this isn't against the gays.
Mm-hmm.
What he's trying to say is, Danny, you're subhuman. You're a homo. You're a gay. You're with other people.
Right. It's, none of those things are subhuman. It's it's ridiculous to even act like that is an insult. I mean, is this 2009? It's now so outrageous for someone to be gay?
Mm. No, but the thing is, you don't want to be called that.
There's nothing wrong with being called it. It's not an insult. He thinks he's insulting, and he's not.
So it's actually, if you say to somebody, fag, you're complimenting them.
I don't know if that term is the right way to go, but
how
there's
about
nothing...
Homo?
There's not. I think homo is all right. There's nothing wrong with being gay.
Hey, Dave, you're a homo. Hey,
Ron.
That's great, right?
Come on, Ronnie.
That's great.
You're funny.
Yeah.
You're funny to me.
But what it is a compliment.
Yeah.
You're a homo.
Okay, I know. Hicks. Thanks. Thank you, buddy.
Hey, Hicks, you're a homo.
Oh, thanks.
Hey.
Thank you. Ron, you're a homo, I tell you.
Oh, Jesus.
Say it again. Do me a fucking favor and
no!
say it again. Don't you ever insult my family like that again.
I know, we were having fun.
Don't you ever insult my family.
It's not an insult or a compliment. It's just a fact of life.
Right.
And there's nothing wrong. It's like calling somebody, you know, black or who's black.
Yes, exactly.
Or calling somebody who's Catholic, you know, it doesn't matter.
That's what I try to do. I try to say, like, if my friend is cheap, I'll try to say, oh, you're a Jew. And then everybody gets mad at me. When what I'm really trying to do is compliment him.
That's not a compliment, being called cheap.
So you don't think Colin's dropping the M-bomb is an insult?
I think that's a slur, yes. But there's
Is it a compliment or not? I can't understand. What is it that you're upset about?
I'm upset about the homophobic slurs in Little Nicky's song. Like, he's acting like that is so horrible. And there's nothing wrong with it. It shouldn't be the insult.
Well, yeah, I mean, if you take out the disgusting parts, it's definitely legal.
Of course it is.
Fez, did you see this guy who had the, he was like a Catholic guy who's against the gay marriage? And now he's divorcing his wife for 43 years.
Yeah, yeah, it's preserve that sanctity.
Yeah.
Do what you can there. Do what you can. Stop people in love from getting married because you got such a handle on it yourself.
Now, normally I'm for everybody doing what they want, but the gay marriage thing, won't abide.
Why?
Doesn't make sense. Oh, I'll ask you this. What happens during a bachelor party? Who goes? Everyone?
Everyone could be at the bachelor party. Well, you got two bachelors.
Yes, but that's not a bachelor party.
Have two bachelor parties.
And then they don't go to each other's?
You know, maybe they do, maybe they don't.
We'll try to figure it out. We used to have a way of being. Now it's like nothing matters. There's no thing. Now, Dave, if you were in a gay marriage.
Right. Oh, jeez.
Now, if you were in a gay marriage, right?
Yeah.
You had a bachelor party. Would you invite your soon-to-be husband?
I guess, like, you're supposed to?
Yeah, but then why even have a bachelor party?
Yeah, no, I guess
now it's the reception.
It's the
Now etiquette. It's just the reception again.
Yeah, I guess I wouldn't. But then mutual friends of ours wouldn't be able to come either.
Yeah, that doesn't make sense. Now it'd be like this. You wouldn't have the person because this is supposed to be your last night, right?
Right.
But then you're not going to invite your best buddy to your bachelor party?
Because what if they're the maid of honor?
Yeah, it's got to stop.
They're not supposed to come.
Oh. Stanley, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, yeah, I just want to comment about that song, man. I thought that was a pretty hilarious song. Even though they're making fun of Danny, you know, but that's all right. But the song was good.
So the song part you liked?
Yeah, the song part I liked. You know,
did you like the song?
I didn't think of it as any homophobic gestures or statements or anything like that. I just thought they were making fun. That's all.
No. So what all he was saying, Fez, you're just having fun.
No, I don't think it's fun at all. And it's definitely not funny. Little Nicky's song. It wasn't funny. There was nothing there.
What don't you like about it?
I don't like the homosexual slurs in it, where he acts like he's attacking Danny with something that isn't any reason to attack about. Whether Danny is or isn't gay, it doesn't even matter.
See, the heterosexuals, we don't have a problem. Like, if someone says, what are you doing, chick fucker? Why don't you go off and lick pussy? Why don't you go put a fucking pussy on the end of your dick?
Mm-hmm.
Hetero's not going to be upset with that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I don't know where this Little Nicky's coming from. If he thinks that's comedy.
Little Dicky is more like it. Like, a little more gay homo is what we should call him. He's the homo, right, Fez?
It wouldn't matter if he was.
I'm just saying.
It's not an insult. It's nothing to say to him.
Right, but still, I bet he does. Bet
he probably is.
I bet he likes to fucking play with someone's balls.
Oh, God.
Right? It wouldn't matter if he did.
I'm trying to be on your side. I'm saying he's the gay one. He's the awful kid toucher.
Yeah.
No, that's not it. That's
then
not being on my side,
then
Ronnie.
I'm confused. All right. Who's the fag, then? Who are we going to get? Aren't we against Nicky?
We're against Nicky, yes.
Good. Because he's the gay.
Yeah.
He's the gay.
That's not the way to be against him.
How he wants us to be against us is our cock against his ass crack.
I'm not doing that.
He'd love it.
Nicky. Little Nicky.
Little Dicky sucker. Fez? Dicky
sucker. No, I'm not participating in that.
Why don't he go suck a dick? He's so gay. right?
It would be fine if he wanted to. There would be no problem with it. It's nothing.
Oh, I'd love to get fucking video of that.
It's nothing to put in what's supposed to be, I guess, an insult song.
Well, there is some insult. Like when he calls somebody gay.
No, that's not an insult.
Hey, T, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Fezzy, did you say it doesn't make a difference whether Danny's gay or not?
Yeah.
Yes, I did.
Well, it's not a Monday. Don't try and out anybody.
It's Out Your Friends Monday. Out Your Friends Monday.
Out Your Friends. Out Your Friends. Joe in Rhode Island.
Hey, Ryan D.
Yeah.
Hey, fuck that little Nicky. You're going to have to beat me to him. I'll fuck him up. It's XM all over Sirius. Fuck them. Get them.
I love your attitude, brother. I love it. Let's get that little gay.
No, we don't get gays.
Because we're straight. But what I'm saying is this. Let's say the worst possible thing about him that we can.
All right.
He's a homosexual.
That's not the worst thing.
What's worse?
I don't know. Make fun of his lousy haircut.
Who cares about that?
Exactly. Well, it's the same as the gay thing.
You could be like, his haircut is so gay.
Right. Where'd you go? Gay barber?
Yeah.
That wouldn't be the way to go about it.
Let's make up a sign. I saw little Nicky at the gay pride parade.
That's gay.
There would be no problem with that. This little Nicky is an asshole who thinks he's being clever by calling somebody gay?
Yeah, that's the funny part. He is good. Don't get me wrong.
It makes no sense to me.
You never heard of that before? Ann. Lost you, buddy. Kevin. Kevin in Virginia.
Yeah, I just wanted to tell Fezzy that I like Lil Nicky's song almost as well as I like the Faggot of the Opera.
The Faggot of the Opera. Yes, that was a long time ago. I would hope everyone's progressed along with me.
Well, you are the leader. You are the society's leader.
I would like
You're cutting edge.
It's absolutely ridiculous, that song that he did.
Right. Little Nicky, more like Little Faggy. Right?
No.
I don't understand.
No, Ron.
No. I can't call him Little Hetero.
Wouldn't fit.
No.
Sexuality shouldn't have anything to do with it.
And yet it does.
It's not an insult.
But it is, though. That's the weird thing.
He's trying to make it that way, but it's not.
Well, he didn't invent it.
It's just stupid. It's childish. It's lame.
Faggy.
I don't think that's the way to call it.
How about Wake 'em Up? Oh, there's the queer with a beer. Some kind of song like that. Little Nicky sucking on a dicky.
That's not the way to answer back, Ronnie.
Comes in his mouth and it's all feeling sticky.
Yeah.
Having a time, having a time. here's JD, JD in Philly.
Hey, Ronnie. Hey, Fezzy.
Yeah.
You know, I found out today I have cancer and it looks inoperable. My wife left me for another guy. I'm going to lose my house and be out in the street, but you know what? At least I'm not gay.
Every time I hear that accent, I think fucking Flathead is fucking chopping. Oh, here's our good friend Death Metal Mo. Hey, Mo.
Gentlemen, Wally Posse Foot Soldier, 9170, checking in.
What's up, buddy?
Mr. Fez, this is real good, man. Posse hasn't done anything in a while. Could you do me a favor and sign on to RonFez.net with an enemies list, and we will start systematically attacking and eliminating all your targets, sir.
That would be great, Fez.
If we need to.
Get the posse going.
Yeah. Thank you, Death Metal Mo, and the Watley Posse.
You got a posse?
Mm-hmm. They're out there.
I don't get it, though. We gotta get that Nicky. A little femme. Acts like a fucking girl.
With a pussy.
Yeah, fag.
One with a pussy.
All right, see, that's not the way to get him, though.
How do we get him?
Oh, from poppers.
Dick slap him?
No.
Put the poppers on cocks.
What are you saying, Fez? You're confusing today.
I'm saying
this is why everybody thinks you're crazy.
I'm saying that if he's going to go after Danny in a song,
right,
go after some legitimate things. Don't just call him gay. It's meaningless.
Where? Earth 2?
No. Earth Prime, Earth 1, whatever we
are. If it's meaningless, why would anybody get upset about it?
Because he's trying to make it an insult.
Trying?
Yes. That's what he's trying to do.
Ooh, I thought it was one.
I'm saying that
I'm
he's
just
failing.
Going by the Bible.
I don't remember it being an insult in the Bible.
Well, he said don't lay with other men.
Don't fuck them either.
Well, of course, that's what they meant. They can't curse in the Bible.
Oh.
Except for when they said the cock crows. That made me laugh in fucking catechism. And they were going, what's so funny? I said, you know, about the crowing. Walker, you're on FS.
Hey, buddies. Yeah. I got a spy report.
What do you got?
I just saw little Nicky in the waiting room of the doctor's office. He told me that he just got some testing done. He's gay. He's got HIV, so apparently he is gay.
Here's Mike in Long Island.
Hey, how you doing? Okay. Something tells me little Dickie's had more balls on his nose than a circus seal.
Now that's fucking funny. You don't think it's funny?
No, it's not funny.
Balls
it's
on his
too
nose.
Cheap. It's too cheap.
What are you fucking laughing at now?
The balls with the seal.
Look, you know, everything you said is going against you.
Yeah, that's what he does. And I don't, you know, I...
You appreciate it?
No, I wouldn't expect a dope like him to do it, to not laugh at something like that.
Good one.
I was just picturing a seal with balls on it.
What about my lips are sealed?
Like, imagine if a seal had balls on it.
See what he's doing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nothing.
Yep, he's trying to undermine again. That's what he does. That's the plan. That's what he tries to do. Every single fucking day. That's what he tries to do.
Do you have to work blue, though?
Sometimes I do.
Every day? Is it starting to annoy you, though?
Oh, sure, yeah.
I know.
Yeah. It's very annoying. It's very frustrating. I don't know when he's going to get a clue.
Why would he do it?
Because he thinks what's going to happen is I'm going to lay down and sit here and let him do it.
See what he's playing?
He was.
So that's your way of dealing, take out the production? Tony. Tony, you're on Running Fez.
Hey, buddies, I think little Dickie's had his wiener in more buns than Oscar Mayer.
Was that joke funny, Fez?
No. I didn't find it funny at all.
More wieners in your bun than Oscar Mayer.
No, it's not funny. It's immature. It's stupid. Dave can fake laugh all he wants.
Funny to me.
Were you fake laughing?
Of course he's fake laughing.
No, because I was
You ever hear him do that Muttley laugh before? Never.
Yeah, I've heard it. Stupid, yeah, but he does do it. You don't like Dave?
No, I don't care for him at all.
Earl just gave me the update that Les Paul is dead at 94.
Mars came in too before it tells him Les Paul's dead.
And I understand Twitter's blowing up with the Les Paul news. Everyone likes to be the first one to Twitter.
But they never are. There's actual journalists who do this for a living. Right. You'll never be the person who breaks the story.
But everybody wants to tell you. Have you ever wanted to tell your friends somebody's dead?
Yeah. I have, but then I've gotten out of that habit because I know that they know already.
Ryan, you're on Fez.
Hey, Fez, I just wanted to say, you know, you're always ripping on Dave. But you're always making it about yourself. Why?
How am I making this about myself? I'm talking about a song that little Nicky did about Danny.
So yeah, but then you always rip on Dave for it. It's always about him.
That's true. He's the one taking shots at me.
Because you always make it about yourself.
No, I
Why?
Don't, you idiot. No,
you
I don't. I was just I'm not going to let him sit here and try and bash me on my own fucking show, asshole.
Please,
it's not going to happen. It's
Dave,
not going to happen.
You always make it on you?
I don't
yes,
think.
It is. Yes.
I don't feel like I've bashed anybody. I really
no,
don't.
No, you don't have the fucking guts to come right after me, so you do your fucking fake laughs. You do all that shit. You say things under your breath, like GVAC brought up on RonFez.net when he nailed your ass yesterday. No, you never come right after me.
Doesn't have the balls.
You make a comment, and then you look at Ron, hoping that, you know, that you can cozy
well,
up to him.
He does. He tries to cozy up. That
totally
is fucking
does.
True.
I don't do hey, that.
You just
I
did it right now.
Yeah. I look at Ron because I'm a human being.
Hey, by the way, did you hear my text go off?
No.
Yeah, it did. And it was Les Paul, rest in peace, from East Side Dave. While you were talking. Tim, you're on my Fez.
Yeah, hey, Fezzy. I want to know who's gotten hit in the chin with more balls, Jorge Posada or you?
All right. He's got a catcher's mask on.
I have no idea who the guy is.
Catcher for the
so
Yankees.
So it could be you then. Hammer.
What's up, players?
What can we do for you?
Hey, Fez, you know, there is one thing that's in the world that's, you could be called that's worse than gay, and that's Third Mike. Peace!
I'm not Third Mike here.
The show doesn't have one. There's two co-hosts and producers.
As he puts that out there, so now Fez is the lunatic, Fez is the bad guy, Fez picks on Dave too yeah. much. Yeah, put it out there again.
And then you look naive for saying there's a plan.
Sure, exactly. That's how it works. Play the victim constantly, whether it's in here, whether it's online.
You're the victim, dude. You bring it up every single day. You instigated this once again.
When did I instigate it?
For the eighth day in a row, you bring it up. Jay Moore was my
You know
fault
what?
Yesterday.
I'll do it any fucking day I want. You know why?
Because
it's the fucking Ron and Fez show.
Great.
So I'll do it any fucking day I want.
Excellent. But don't call me a victim when I'm not.
You just played it again.
How?
They're under this co-host here so. And producers. Everyone,
I'm doing
please.
Production for the show. That actually wasn't even an attack. You said the word plan. Both Ron and Fez said the word plan a bunch of times. So, in a nebulous fashion. So, I intercut it with Plan 9 from Outer Space. There was nothing attacking about it. I didn't fuck with the audio or do anything. I made it into a production piece. Because that's what I thought we're trying to get towards. Did the same thing with Fred and Chris. Put it with music. The same thing yesterday. I'm going to do something today, probably with some audio from Ron. I'm just trying to fucking do other stuff. That's why I'm here so late.
Oh, yes, yes. You're here very late every day. Yes, that awful, awful Fez.
I didn't say it was because of you.
Oh, it's horrible. What Fez does to you. Oh. And then he just... then all Fez does is attack. Fez must be crazy.
No, but you're the proponent of this war for some reason.
I am? Maybe I'm saying it straight out.
There is no plan. There never has been. There's no plan, no battle, no ulterior motives. There's only attempted contributions to the radio show.
Maybe I'm just saying it out loud and not making snide remarks, fake laughs, message board posts.
If there was a real plan, shouldn't something be done about it? Wouldn't you speak to me and say, is there a plan?
866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Here is Jay. Jay in Nevada.
Hey, guys. Hey, Fezzy. It's kind of, I respect you for trying. It's hard to take you serious as a tough guy. Weren't you crying an hour and a half ago because the caller made you sad?
I'm going around an emotional roller coaster here, buddy.
How come, buddy?
It's just all right at the surface.
But why?
I don't know why. I don't know. I don't know what got me going earlier.
Mm-hmm.
I know what gets me going now. That's Eastside Dave.
How did I bring any of this up? How did I bring up the thing yesterday? You're accusing me of a remark that Jay Moore said. So I stayed silent the entire show. If you go back and listen to this stuff every single day, it's like a Cal Ripken streak of you bringing it up. I'm not talking to you. You asked me not to talk to him or to Fez, so I'm not talking.
Well, you both broke that. You both broke that. And I didn't see Nico over there. Come on in, Nico. When did he get here?
Standing on a chair.
Why would anybody come in and go to that room? I honestly...
They like the Chris Stanley.
Yeah. Nico was one of our interns, and now looks like he's a million years old.
He looks like he was in THX-1138.
What are you doing completely shaved down, Stone Cold?
Well, I gave in to the baldness. So I just shaved everything.
You're young.
22.
22, and you're already bald for life.
And you did the complete shave down.
Complete shave down. Everything's gone.
No, you were always a kid that was on the ball. You saw what just happened with Fez and and Dave here.
I've been listening to it. And
what do you think the problem is?
I can't even begin to see like where this started. It just like burst. It's like it's been boiling. All of a sudden, just a burst came out.
A lot of
nowhere.
People think it's a bit. Is this a bit, Fez?
It is not a bit.
Is it a bit, Dave?
The way my chest feels right now, it is not a bit.
No. You're killing him.
And he's killing me.
You understand you're giving him a heart attack,
I'm not trying to, but, you know, I stay up late at night. I'm a father of two kids who is totally stressed out over this deal. I come in. I don't sleep at night. I don't sleep on the bus.
Why are you stressed out?
Because this wears on me. To think that I have some...
Do you feel like you're going
to
lose your job?
Some sort of plan to co-host. I would never in a million years co-host with Ron because I know I couldn't. So it's never been an option. I've never called myself Third Mike. I don't want that job. I'm a happy producer of the Ron and Fez show. You know why? Because I like to... A Third Mike doesn't do production like little shits like that that I did, that I'm happy to do, that I enjoy doing, that I enjoy putting openings for game shows and a lot of the other shit that you hear. I enjoy that. I speak sometimes on the show. I get asked to contribute verbally. That shouldn't make me a fucking bad guy, nor should it make me people think I'm scheming to take over Fez's chair. I don't want it. Never would. Never will. Happy in my lot in life. Not everyone can be the fucking man. Not everyone can be the absolute superstar.
Here is Jeff in Ohio.
What's going on, fellas? How are you?
What's up?
Hey, you know, I'm sitting here listening, and I've never called in before, but I'm kind of disturbed because Fez kind of forgets. Like, when he had his heart problems and everything, Dave came right in, took over second mic, and was there, you know, letting Ron, you know, talk to him. It can't just be the Ron show. You know, Fez doesn't... You know,
right, let's let Fez answer that. Fezzy, what do you say to that?
Yeah, you know what? And I have said I appreciated that when I had two heart attacks and Dave did step up. Now, don't also, I mean, there's two sides to that, too. That's Dave trying to make a name in radio and getting a fantastic opportunity when I did need him to step up. So, I mean, that's also a good thing for Eastside Dave as well. There's two sides to that.
Hasn't paid out for him.
Dave, well, that's not my fault either. But that's Dave also getting an opportunity on this show, on the Ron and Fez show. But what also happened along the way is Dave thought, if Dave was helping me, Dave also thought he could start taking shots at me every day. You know, if I bring up something like, you know, a fantasy football draft party, he goes and starts acting like I've said the most outrageous thing in the world. It's ridiculous the lame attempts he would try to do to make me look bad to the audience, to the callers, and everyone else.
Chuckling, to me, is not going after someone.
But here's
if someone says something that's funny, if Ron makes a joke at Fez's expense and I laugh, or if you say something that I find amusing and I've laughed at things that you say when you're intending them to be funny as well. Even this week, when you've said funny shit, I've laughed at them if you go back and listen to these shows. Laughing is something...
I couldn't.
I chuckle. I'm a chuckler. I've tried really hard to
live...
You're
a fake laugher.
No, never. Yeah. I try my
totally.
Best. Totally. If I laughed all the times I wanted to laugh in here, I'd laugh... about an hour and a half if you added it up. I don't. I try my best not to laugh all the time. But that's who I am. I'm a human being who likes to laugh. That's it.
Here's our good friend, Jersey Rich.
Hey, buddies. Yeah. Hey, now that Fez has accepted the role of third Mike, maybe you can stop doing Opie impressions.
I haven't accepted shit, asshole. I'm not accepting anything here.
Is that really Jersey Rich?
Rich. Rich. I couldn't tell.
I see that you're totally, like, just bursting right now. Like, where would your ideal situation be?
You sound like a shrink, Nico. Shrinks say to you.
Yeah.
I'm not here for you to analyze me.
Have you been to a shrink?
Yeah, but I'm not too big on the shrink.
I see that you're confused right now. What would you like the situation to be?
Well, it's active listening. I'm trying to make sure that I understand the situation.
Yeah, but you now what are you, a salesman?
Yes, I am a salesman.
Oh, Jesus. Doug, you're running Fez.
Hey, boys. Listen, Fezzy, remember when Earl used to be there and Ron would just hammer him left and right for screw-ups or saying the wrong thing or doing the wrong thing? Have you not noticed since Earl's been gone, Ron's been doing that to you?
I don't think so.
Well, let's go back to that. When Earl left, Fez also said, I'll take the executive producer role.
Right.
So, if anything, I don't have an executive producer. The company isn't moving on it. We talked to our agent about it yesterday. We also talked to our agent yesterday about getting Dave a bump up. Says they're not doing it right now. But, again, you know, we are in the situation that we're in. We can't sit around and act like these things didn't happen. But if Fez tells me I'm doing booking, I'm going to look for him for the booking stuff. If he told me, hey, I'm not doing booking, I don't want to, that would be fine. I've tried to take him off booking how many times, Fez?
Just about every week.
Yeah. We are, Miss Earl, but he fucking walked out. And we haven't been able to fill the fucking position. We had somebody we wanted to put there, couldn't do it. Matter of fact, that was somebody that Fez, that Dave used to tease with, Earl. Fucking Fez is playing the Earl bit with Dave right now. You're doing exactly the same stuff. Exactly the same stuff that Earl did with him.
Well, I'm trying to put it out there. I'm not fucking Earl. I don't want him doing it.
That would make sense if you did it off the air. But you only do it on the air. You've never sat down and had a talk with him, right?
No.
Same deal. Become show fodder. 866-RUN-0-FEZ. 866-RUN-0-FEZ. What are you selling now, Nico?
I'm selling health and life insurance. And, it's just... It's at the point... Because I was trying to get into radio, and I was applying everywhere. I'm still doing a part-time gig. But other than that, it's just a giant heap of shit.
I'm doing a big show on Saturday night. Mark Zito's College Radio.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's fantastic. We'd love to have you stop in sometimes. We would love it.
Sure, I'd definitely be there.
That's on Stars 2 at midnight this Saturday.
Can't wait. That's the only show on Saturday.
Oh, no, we're live, too.
I can only promote one show at a time.
Oh, okay.
I don't want to promote the show that asked me on. John in Washington.
Yes. Hey, Dave, I got your back here. And Fez, are you ever going to accept any responsibility for your own problems?
Enough. As we do you the same calls over and over. Starts to drive me crazy. Paul in Texas. Paul.
Hey, Ron. You know, Fez, I think, first of all, I'm a Fez fan. I'm not a big Eastside Dave fan at all. But I think you're mad at Ron and can't go off on Ron. You know, nothing could happen in that show that Ron didn't allow. And I think that's what you're mad about. You know, if Ron didn't want Dave saying the things he was saying, he'd shut him down. He'd just take him off the air, just, you know, you are not talking. So I think it's all.
You're 100% right there. If I wanted to say, Dave, get away from the mic, I would. And by the same token, Fez can say, Dave, get away from the mic. Fez always says it's the Ron and Fez show.
Right, yes. It
but
is.
You let him be planted right there in front of the mic. And why is that? Because you went away today for fuck. I had to pull you into the show today.
Right.
I had to pull you into the show. And are we talking about any of the topics we were talking before? No. We're back talking about Fez and what makes him angry. If you had this kind of passion about the topics, nobody would fucking get caught up in your stuff. We would not be talking about you. We'd be talking about all the shit we brought up in the first fucking hour.
Yeah, I mean, I understand that. It's, and I am working on it.
The same passion you have for fighting with fucking Dave, have whatever comes up without taking it on personally. Here's somebody, Fezzy, who's always been there for us. It's Paranoid.
Hey, Ron and Fez, what's happening, buddy?
Hey, Paranoid.
You know what, Fez, I applaud you. I agree with you. As somebody that works in the industry doing little game show themes, I'm always trying to bump somebody out of a job. So don't let Eastside Dave tell you he's not trying to take your job. You know what's going on. Don't let anybody change your mind. I applaud you, man. You're an inspiration.
And you said you'd be doing the same thing, Perry, if you were in here as Dave's doing.
Absolutely. In fact, I do something like this down in Atlanta. I do jingles and stuff like that for the Giant Show. But I'm always looking to cut someone's throat so I can move up the ladder.
Who would you like to move out of that Giant Show?
El Jefe.
Yeah.
Chafee. Anybody. Especially a co-hosting position. Jeez, I'd stab my own mom in the back for that.
Mm. Well, you did that anyway just because you said the dog told you to?
Well, we don't talk about that. I'm not allowed to talk about that anymore. I'm a father now, so I don't need the CPS rolling in on me.
Perry, I want to put you on hold, and a dull young Jewish boy is going to talk to you about your insurance. I know you're a father now.
I appreciate that. Yeah. I need some.
You got it.
Have you sold any insurance yet, Nico?
No, I've been waiting for my license. New York State is the slowest pile of shit ever. I mean, you're supposed to apply online, and the online server goes down. It goes, I started on Friday. Oh, it's going to be back Monday. Monday goes into Tuesday. Now it's just down indefinitely. So I had to send it by mail.
What are you going, door to door? Old style?
No, we send
ma'am?
Out...
Ma'am? Well, emails?
We send out letters, and then we call the people that we send letters to.
Yeah, I'd love to get that call.
There's a lot of hang-ups.
Could I get insurance on Watley right now?
Yeah, you can get some insurance.
If something happens to his heart, I'll get paid off?
Yeah.
What's the over-under? What's the action like?
Well, we'd have to work out a little details behind the scenes. But
is there a physical involved?
You know he's got two stents.
Yeah. Getting approved would probably be a hassle. Because that's
pre-existing condition?
That's what's ridiculous right now.
Well, you can make that happen, right?
Oh, yeah. I'll call in some favors. Of course, for Ron and Fez.
Just blur out the heart part. Just smudge everything.
Yeah.
Then they'll look at the brain. Are you calm down now, Fezzy?
I think so.
What if tomorrow there's no talk about Dave?
All right, I will do that.
And Dave, can you do one day where you don't make fun of him?
Yes, I can.
I don't believe either one of them. Do you believe them, Nico?
I can't at this point. I see the look on both of their faces. I think something's going to break.
You think they hate each other?
I don't see love in their eyes at all. And all you need is love.
We were supposed to play that as an opening today, right? I sent it to both you guys.
I think...
What? Because the guy that was getting the kidney operation, he asked for it. We'll come back for it. What's his name? It's Frankie.
I don't know. I didn't get it.
Neither of you guys got this email.
Didn't receive it. It was sent last night. I didn't receive it.
Let me see if I'm insane here. I'm going to go back and check. I know he wanted to hear some Beatles. I'll go and check on it. Okay. All right, we're going to come back. What's that?
Okay.
You found it?
No, I didn't find it. I'm saying okay.
Okay, to what?
You said, we'll play some Beatles. I go, okay.
All right. Right back, Ron and Fez show.